Spelling develops a sensitivity towards your hand. Okay, so it gets you to understand how to grab better water. Okay, so if you can do it tight like we were talking about earlier, you can find any good place to grab water depending on how you want to move your body. Okay, but what we're going to talk about now is full strokes. Okay, when we talk about full strokes, we're talking about the competitive strokes being freestyle, backstroke, butterfly, and breaststroke. Okay. Not sure if I have time to get into breaststroke today. But we're going to start with the dynamic of the strokes. Okay. The dynamic of the stroke is such that it has three phases. The three phases are known as the catch, the power phase, and the recovery. Okay. Recovery simply means your arm goes back to the starting position. The catch and the power phase are the really important ones. Okay. The catch refers to your first grip of the water. When you go from standing to pulling. Okay. In the same way, you can't go from standing to a full-out sprint in one step, so too can you not get your hardest pull in the first grab. Okay? So what I'm going to have you guys do with one single stroke, what you're going to do is you're going to start from our initial top position, you're going to grab down in the water, and then you're going to accelerate and launch out the back and leave it in back. Okay? So again, push off, grab down, accelerate, pull. Okay? Something is going to be happening to you that you're not expecting. We'll talk about that in a second. Okay?
Can you repeat that one more time?
Yes. Push off the wall, grab down, accelerate, hold out the back.
One okay? stroke.
One stroke. It's going to look like it. Push off.
Almost there. moving my hands.
Make sure you're keeping a nice line here. You start with this one in and out of the side. Yeah, good job. There you go.
It's a body-driven oscillation, right? So people think when
when they're doing this specific style of kicking, they think it's leg driven. And that's where you're all out of whack. It's body driven, right? So if I can establish the priorities as we've discussed it so far, buoyancy, head position, body position, arm drive, okay? So now what we're starting to tap into is how the arms fit in to these up and down oscillations, okay? So we'll talk about double arm pushing dynamics and what happens there. When one arm pushes and one arm reaches, forward movement and rotation are the outcomes, okay? When two arms push, forward movement and upward movement are the outcome. Regardless of which stroke we're talking about, if it's two arm pushes like butterfly, or if it's a two arm skull like breaststroke, that is responsible for the upward phase. Okay? What we can then understand is that to complete the oscillation and short axis rotation, we need to make sure that we have a balance of down. Okay? The arms provide the upward moment, the body essentially provides the downward moment. And between those two things, we have balance. Okay? So what we'll have you guys do is we'll start with the skull, because that one's easier to pull off. Okay? So the skull is something you're already kind of used to. What I'll have you guys all do is create kind of like a heart shape with your arms. Okay? So start with your arms out in front. You're going to create a heart shape here. Heart goes towards your heart and then back out. Okay? So you start with an outward swoop, inward swoop, back in again. You recognize we're creating a nice... And if you do this on the surface, look at the heart shape you're actually creating on the surface. That's how you know you have a good skull. And watch your surface tension. Watch the water you're moving. Make sure it's a heart and not a tomato. Okay? Make sure it's a heart and not a tomato, everybody. Okay. So then cut the angle, right? So this is a tomato. This is a heart. Okay? See the shape of the surface. Exactly. Tighten. Alright, so again, this stroke will create what type of movement? Up. If you do that stroke, up is what happens, okay? And then, after your arms go back down in front, we're not gonna get to it yet, but eventually, we're gonna create a downward moment, okay? We're gonna go up. And the circuit is complete, okay? Right, so, and that should be allowed to travel. Start with just a single push off the wall, single stroke, feel that heart-shaped pull drive, you are towards the surface, stand up. Okay? Do the one, stand up, turn around, we'll go and do it a bunch of times. Okay? Go ahead, bro. Look. Heart-shaped, not tomato. It ends here. Good. Good. You're too low. Go to here. Sharpen those angles. Make sure about it. Good. You've lifted your head up to help out. Use the stroke. Feel the pressure in your knees. Okay? Good. Went a little too low, but you still got that right top. Yes. Good. You really pushed yourself up on that. You have a tighter angle, and you can still have a little too low. Okay. Yeah. Good. Better. You're more connected to that. You have to put in some number to keep your hands in the way. You had more emphasis on this and less emphasis on this. Okay? So take a beat, guys. That's an important moment to have. Okay? So, real quick, if we're going to tie in the conversation of catch, power phase, and recovery. Catch, power phase, and recovery, okay? We start slow, okay? With regard to this particular stroke pattern, this is your catch, this is your power phase, this is your recovery, okay? Grab the water, power in, back to position, okay? So what we had here was he put too much power on the front, and then this thing was soft, He didn't create the movement. He was pulling himself forward rather than pulling himself upward. Grab the water, pull the water in, back to position. Okay? A couple more times and we'll stop here. Go a little heady, but you got the right idea. Better. Okay, don't go too low with those arms. Yeah. Yep. You still not too far down. Okay, you can have your waist and shoulder up. You can bring your strain into your chest. Heart goes to your heart. Stay high. You're really getting that good pop on that thing. Good. So you still got the upward thrust, right? But so if it's too low, you're going to be thrusting your midsection up. If it's out in front of you, you're going to thrust in front of you up. And also keep it out in front of you. Right? Here. Up high. Yes. There. Keep going.
It seems
like everybody's gotten the beat on how to thrust themselves up out of the water. Okay? Let's work on diving back down. Okay? If you put enough intensity into that forward reach, the downward phase naturally happens by itself. Right now, let your head be a little bit more active with it. Okay? So you're gonna come up with that arm stroke, you're gonna dive back down with a little bit of extra headiness, and again, the breath is built into the mechanics, right? You pop yourself up, this is your window, back down again. Pop yourself up, this is your window, back down again. And you don't need to breathe every single time, okay? You can breathe every other, that's fine too. You don't have to breathe, you can work on that later, okay? But again, the mechanics involve the timing for your breath. The mechanics of the stroke create the window in which you can breathe. Okay, so again, 2 to 3 repetitions, stroke in, dive down, stroke in, dive down, like so. Okay, and if you guys feel like you need to have more power from it, bring it from here. Allow yourself that initial movement to come from your head. Eventually, we're going to try to make it so that your head doesn't do anything, so you get a little bit more rigidity, a little bit more speed, a little less oscillation, tighter movement through the water, okay? Go on, try it out. Dive, guys. Up and down. Play with it. Dive. 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 Good. Stroke, dive. Stroke, dive. Stroke, dive. No stroke, all dive, but I like where your head goes.
I think I didn't have this one enough.
Okay, I watch again. Okay, so you will have problems if you spend too much time in one phase or the other. We need to have balance. If you go too low with your stroke and you go too high, recognize that you need a complement to that. If you're here, you need to go way here. Okay, I want you guys to watch how Jen has this nice complement of the up and down. Go ahead. Don't be weird. Let's go. Up, waste no time, down. Waste no time, down. Waste no time, down. There's no waste. Very good. Try it again, guys. There you go. Guys, you had to dive harder. You had fit in. Remember, the arms do the up, the head and arms diving down do the down. Okay?
Thank you.
observation that somebody's being affected with their culture. Again, the question was, how do we know by observation with whether or not somebody's being affected with the culture? With the culture. So we had a discussion about the rotation and balance. So if one side is turning more than the other, we're not being affected as affected with one or the other, okay? And then so again, the one stroke pulling, one stroke reaching phenomenon creates what kind of move? Forward and? No. Side to side is this. For me, we're talking rotation. I think we're talking about the same thing, but I'm an asshole. Okay. Rotation, twist and turn, right? If they're doing anything else, besides going forward and twisting and turning, then they're not being accurate. If they're leaning this way or this way, if they're going up and down when they should be twisting and turning, okay? I'll demonstrate what I'm talking about now. First four strokes, I'm going to be pulling poorly. You guys see what happens. Last strokes, I'm going to be pulling better. Okay?
I won!
Make a difference. Okay? Too much up and down on the first part, clean, tight rotation on the last part. Okay? So that's how you're going to see and or feel whether or not you're being affected with how you're pulling, right? It's all cause and effect, okay? Go and try it again. We'll do a couple more rounds like this, then we're start talking about kicking dynamics.
Thank you.
consistent rotation?
Yeah.
Sure.
started with the notion of breath regulation earlier, in action, it becomes a lot more complex, right? But with the principles we discussed, understanding tempo, pacing, buoyancy, limitations, what provides you the opportunity to breathe, it sets you up with, I feel like, a decent enough foundation. Anybody have any questions? Yeah. Layering worked out pretty well for you guys. I wanted to do more things. You guys took me a slightly different direction, but I think I like where it went anyway. You guys were great. Thank you for letting me test this out and mess around with it. And hopefully you guys, found some stuff to speak up. And hope you guys use it. Hope you guys use it once.